Welcome to Science Store online classes.
Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.
Okay, my dear students, next we are going to study about hydroboration of alkene. Okay, hydroboration of alkene, actually this the same thing you are studying in alcohol also, the same thing. And how that boration takes place, BH3 is there, each time it will go and attack and it forms like this. Okay, for example, I will show you. See, first you have to take alkene, three molecules of alkene reacts with the borane. Understood? Borane in the presence of tetrahydrofuran and diglyme. What is this diglyme? Diglyme means what? Full form. This is actually bis-2-methoxy-ethyl ether. Understood? This is actually bis-2-methoxy-ethyl ether. It is nothing but a diglyme. Understood? So this is a reagent used actually, and you are getting this one. So I will show you how to get this particular. Within a minute, I will show you. Wait. So note down, my dear student. Bis-2-methoxy-ethyl ether. Over. Is called diglyme. Okay, my dear students, here CH2 double bond CH2 is taken, and here one BH3 is taken. That I will write, my dear students, BH3 is like this, BH. So each time what happens, this bond will go and attack, this will come out and this will attack to this particular. So instead of that, I will show you. No, this is not. Okay, here like this also you can show, otherwise. This will go and attack to this particular, this will come out and this will attack to this particular carbon. Understood? So this is also possible. So we are getting, my dear students, product here. This become CH3, this H will be added to this carbon and this becomes CH3, and here it becomes single bond CH2, and here it becomes BH2. Okay, again it is treated with the alkene, my dear students, again it is treated with the alkene, CH2 double bond CH2. The same procedure will take place here. This will go and attack to this particular. My dear students, I will write like this, H. Understood? Like this. And okay, not like this. This will attack to this particular double bond. Again, this alkene is used. And this will come out. And this will go and attack to this particular carbon. Okay. Again, you are getting, my dear students, in each step, note down, CH3, CH2, B, and 1H is remaining. 1H is added to this carbon and it becomes CH2, CH3. Okay, like this. Again, you are removing this H by adding alkene. Okay, this will go and attack to this particular, and this bond breaks and it will come out and it will attack to this particular, any of the this one. And it gives, my dear students, CH3, CH2, B, CH2, CH3, CH2, CH3. This is actually reaction. In all together, we can say that CH3, CH2, thrice. CH3, CH2, thrice it is attached to B. Correct? No, this is nothing but this one. So, three times you are taking alkene and treated with the borane. So each time when you treat with the borane, you are removing 1H, that H will be added to one of the carbon and double bond. Here B will attack to one of the another carbon. So again you are taking this BS2 attached to this particular, again is treated with the another alkene. And that the same procedure, this will go and attack to this hydrogen That means this hydrogen is added to this carbon, same time this bond breaks and this will go and attack to this particular carbon. Again, third time also you are treating with the alkene. Each time you are removing one hydrogen from that BH3 and total 3 hydrogen is removed, 3 times you are adding alkene. Understood? At the end you are getting CH3, CH2, B, CH2, CH3, B, CH2, CH3. That means 3 molecules of CH3, CH2 thrice. It is represented in a single bracket. CH3, CH2 thrice means here this is actually thrice. Okay. Then again it is treated with the hydrogen peroxide, it gives alcohol. That means here OH is added. The 3 molecule is there, so I am writing here 3 molecules of CH3, CH2, OH. OH plus H3BO3 hydroboric acid. This part H3BO3. In this one, very important thing is you are taking 3 molecules of hydrogen peroxide. 3 molecules of hydrogen peroxide. 3 molecules of hydrogen peroxide means, imagine my dear students, single molecule of hydrogen peroxide means OH, OH. Like 3 molecules means 6 OH is there. So, 3 OH will be added here. That means 3 OH and 3 more OH is here. This is boric acid. The same in single step reaction it is given like this. It's very simple my dear students, please go through this. So this equation is very important. Hydroboration. My dear students, this is one of the important reaction, Diels-Alder reaction. Diels-Alder reaction. You can like that. You can call Diels-Alder reaction. D-I-E-L-S. Diels-Alder reaction. The reaction is also called cycloaddition. That means you are getting cyclic compound. Cyclic compound form. Understood? Cycloaddition. And a conjugated diene is attacked by an olefin which is called dienophile. Dienophile. My dear students, conjugated diene, dienophile, it's very simple term, okay. Only name is little see. This is called conjugated diene. Diene attacked by who? Actually attacking dienophile. It is not dinosaur. Dienophile. Okay, dienophile means is very simple. CH2. It is ethylene. Ethylene or dienophile. Ethylene or dienophile. Understood? Ethylene is common name. In a standard way of chemistry, dienophile. What is dienophile? So dienophile, some other compound also called dienophile. I will explain. Benzene also called dienophile. That I will give you later. Okay. So this is a dienophile. Okay. Ethylene, it acts as a dienophile. Dienophile. It attacks on this particular. Very simple, my dear students. This comes here. This comes out. This will attack to this particular, this will attack to this particular, like that. Bond formation. My dear students, look at this. This bond attacks here and this bond goes here and this bond comes out and form bond here. And how it looks, my dear students? Like this. This is actually compound. Okay. So, this is called Diels condensation. This particular double bonded ethylene will attack on this particular conjugated diene. This bond attacks on this particular and here this bond comes here and this bond attacks to, double bond attacks to this side. And we are getting product is this one. Okay. Don't get confused. Don't get confused. Very simple. I'll give you some other examples, my dear students. Shall I rub this? So this is conjugated ien. Conjugated diene. So this also acts as a dienophile. For example, this also acts as a dienophile. Dienophile. Okay. This will go and attack to this particular same way it attacks. Here this bond moves here. This bond comes and attack to this particular like this, and it forms a cyclic compound, my dear students. Cyclic compound. So this is okay. Over this much part is covered because this will attack to this one. It forms one bond. This will attack here. It forms one bond, and this will move here. This part is over, and remaining part from here, here. This is called Diels-Alder reaction. Diels-Alder reaction. Note down, my dear student. This is called conjugated diene. This is called dienophile. Dienophile. Okay, next one more. Shall I rub this? My dear students, addition of sulfur dioxide to this conjugated diene, it gives sulfones. Sulfones. How it looks actually, my dear students? Sulfones. One minute. This is called sulfones. This is also Diels-Alder condensation. Diels-Alder, usually it is called Diels-Alder condensation, Diels-Alder condensation you can call. So, but this is special case. Here we are using sulfur dioxide, so it is special case, Diels-Alder condensation. Okay. Cyclic sulfones. S-U-L-P-H-O-N-E-S. Sulfones. Shall I have this? My dear students, so this is called benzene, benzene, benzyl. These all okay. Benzene, right on. Benzene, comma, aline. Alenes, because carbon-carbon double bond between these two is comes, understood? This is called alene. These also act as a dienophiles, and even this also act as a dienophiles, understood? This also act as a dienophiles. All these act as a dienophiles. No doubt, my dear students. Okay, my dear students, next reaction with the sulfur monochloride. Reaction with the sulfur monochloride, okay. S2 Cl2, how it reacts. And very important thing is the product formed is called mustard gas. Mustard gas. The product formed is called mustard gas. Mustard gas. Like mustard ice cream, it is custard ice cream. Custard ice cream, like it forms mustard gas. Okay. Alkene is taken, two molecules of alkene is taken, ethylene. It is treated with the sulfur monochloride. It gives product CH2, CH2, Cl, and here it is connected to sulfur CH2, CH2, Cl. Okay. There is no bond. If I write like Cl here, means you will get confused. There is a bond like this. Cl, CH2, CH2, S, CH2, CH2, Cl. Understood? And plus sulfur. So this is called mustard gas. Like custard ice cream is there, no? It is mustard gas. My dear students, remember alkene is treated with the sulfur monochloride and it gives mustard gas. Mustard gas formula Cl, CH2, CH2, sulfur, CH2, CH2, Cl. It is called mustard gas. Okay, note down my dear students. My dear student, next important thing is allylic substitution. What is allylic carbon? That is very important, my dear students. First, I will explain what is allylic carbon. Which one is called allylic carbon? So, my dear students, carbon so which one is called allylic carbon? That question arises. So carbon attached to carbon-carbon double bond. This is actually carbon-carbon double bond. To this carbon, see here one carbon-carbon, this double bonded carbon is there. To this carbon is attached. This carbon is called allylic carbon. Allylic carbon. Okay, this carbon is attached to carbon-carbon double bonded carbon, then it is called allylic carbon. So, carbon attached to carbon-carbon double bonded carbon, then it is called allylic carbon. Note down, my dear students, by knowing these things only you will come to know that what is allylic carbon. Allylic means this carbon is attached to carbon-carbon double bonded carbon. This carbon is attached to carbon-carbon double bonded carbon. So this carbon and this carbon is called allylic carbon. Allylic carbon. So here in this one you can see this one reaction. This is actually one alkene is taken, reacts with the chlorine in the 750 Kelvin temperature in the presence of HNU, sunlight. What it gives, my dear students? It gives one substituted chlorine here. Chlorine, where it actually gets substituted? Allylic substitution. Which position is called allylic? For CH2, CH2, this position is allylic position. I will write here, my dear students. The same reaction I will show here. Okay. See, CH2, okay, after that CH, this is actually given, this is nothing but bond line representation of this particular, okay, look at this one, this is nothing but the same, these two are same, look at this, in this one carbon-carbon double bond is there. The carbon attached to carbon-carbon double bonded carbon, this carbon is called allylic carbon. Allylic carbon. Correct, my dear students? Allylic carbon. This carbon is called allylic carbon. So, to this carbon, you are adding halogen. So, chlorine is added. How this reaction takes place means, it is free radical mechanism, my dear students. How we can add means, imagine I will write this same thing over here, CH2 double bond, CH single bond, CH, CH, CH is nothing but CH3. Okay, free radical mechanism means this bond breaks, Here two electron is there, correct? One of the bond breaks, one electron move to this side, another electron move to hydrogen. One electron move to carbon, one electron move to hydrogen. So what happens? This bond breaks, correct? And even chlorine is there here, chlorine. This bond also breaks. One electron moves here, one electron moves here. This bond breaks. So here gets a free radical. So what happens? This H and this one of the H and one of the Cl get combines by sharing its electron. Correct? So it forms HCl. One product is HCl. Correct? Second one, here in carbon, this carbon having one single electron, it needs one more electron. This chloride is ready to give that electron to this carbon. Understood? This I will write here, my dear students. One electron moves here, one electron moves here. Now this having free electrons. Okay, these two free electrons, free radical mechanism. Here chloride bond breaks, one electron moves here, one electron moves here. So this bond breaks, and this will form bond, this and this will form bond. So this is separated, HCl gets separated, correct? I will write HCl as a byproduct. So it is separated, understood? And here it forms bond, correct? These two free electrons. What it gives, my dear students? CH2 double bond, CH, CH2, Cl. So same thing it is written here, CH2, CH, CH2, Cl. See, very important note is that chlorine will be get added to the allylic carbon. Chlorine will get added to the allylic carbon. Here it is very important. Which one is allylic carbon? The carbon, it has two carbon-carbon double bonded carbon. This carbon is attached to carbon-carbon double bonded. This is not allylic carbon. This is not allylic carbon. The carbon attached to this carbon. This carbon is considered as allylic carbon. If you are adding chlorine, that chlorine will be added to this carbon. Allylic carbon. Understood? How it added? By free radical mechanism. First chlorine will get separated like this. Bond breaks, one electron moves here, one electron moves here. Now the two free electrons you can see, here one electron, here one electron. Correct? Next, here CH bond is there. That CH bond breaks. Here it moves one electron, here it moves one electron. So now here two free electrons. One of the H will combine with the Cl and that product is separated. Understood? Removed. And this Cl will combine with this carbon, contains free electron. Understood? This will form bond. So it forms CH2 double bond, CH, CH2, Cl. Remaining part remain as it is. My dear students, okay? And here also same reaction. For this is actually carbon-carbon double bond. And this carbon is allylic carbon. This carbon also allylic carbon. So it has X plus here, my dear students. Y means a delocalization is possible. So bromine bond breaks. So here one H is there. 1, 2, 3, 4. One H is there, here CH3, so this H will bond breaks like this, free radical mechanism. Just before I explained, here one H is there, so what happens, that H bond breaks, free radical, one electron here, one electron here to this carbon. So one H will get combined with this, also breaks and it gives byproduct HBr. So I will show you, my dear students, here that reaction if you want. This is allylic carbon. This is allylic carbon, allylic. This is also allylic. But it prefers this side. Why means here electron donor methyl group is there. Electron density increases here. So this side prefer. Understood? So here what happens, my dear students? So this H bond breaks here, here, one of the electron moves here to this carbon, another electron moves to this hydrogen, and in HBr, okay, not HBr, sorry, Br, this bond breaks, one electron moves here, one electron moves here, correct? Now one H and Br will get combined and separated as SBr, and here one free electron is there, that free electron will combine with the this particular Br, so it is HBr, no, not HBr, Br. So this is the product. This is called allylic substitution. Very important, my dear students. Allylic substitution. What is allylic substitution? Very important question. My dear students, in this one allylic substitution, very important note is there. NBS, this is one reagent name. N bromo succinamide. Someone used to pronounce it as succinic acid. Understood, you can call in your own way, understood, I am not forcing you to call succinic acid, it is succinic acid, someone used to call succinic acid, succinamide, understood, so it is succinamide, succinic acid is same, succinamide, you can call it as succinamide, understood, according to your wish, but you should call properly N-bromo succinamide or succinamide, okay, no problem, it is short form NBS, NBS formula is CH2, this is actually NBS, understood. So my dear students, what is the use of NBS means it add bromine, bromination purpose, we are using N-bromosuccinamide, N-bromosuccinamide is used for which purpose? Bromination purpose, okay, selective bromination happens using N-bromosuccinamide. You note down, my dear student, this is one of the very important one, understood, you please note down. Okay, one reaction I will give you. In this one, if we use N-bromosuccinamide, what actually gives, what product you will get? Very simple, this is also, my dear students, I will give you one example. This is one alkene, this is actually allylic carbon. See, this carbon is allylic carbon and this carbon also allylic carbon. Here attachment takes place here, understood, so how it takes place means in the presence of N-bromosuccinamide, so here I didn't write CH2 CH2, it is understood, it is CH2 CH2, okay, don't get confused, sir, here you wrote CH2, where is that CH2, so here what happens, free radical mechanism takes place, here NBr bond breaks, one electron moves to here, one electron moves here, understood, this bond breaks, and here my dear students, here H is there in CH3, look at this, here, how many H is there, here one H, carbon tetravalency, 1 1 2 3 4, one of the H bond breaks, okay. Here, see, makkala, ee bariwaga confusion agbedi. Illi enta meaning? Illi CH3 untu. Idara artha illi CH untu. Double bond. Idara artha illi CH. Ee baridre en meaning? Illi CH2 untu. Ardaita? Illi CH3 untu. Idu actually bond line representation. Nimige gottirbeku. Carbon yavaglu nak bond formation aagtade. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 3, 4. So, I am not writing here H, but meaning is there, here H is there, okay. So, one of the H bond breaks. Ege break agutte? Illi ond electron baruthe ee carbon ge, illi ond electron hydrogen ge hogutte. Aga aa hydrogen matte Br combine agutte. Aga namage enu sigutte? HBr. We will get product HBr. Understood? One. And this N contains single electron, and here it contains one particular, so not NBr. Here it forms N and H. Sorry. Okay. Here N contains single electron. This will combine with this particular H. So it gives product, my dear students. Very simple. C double bond O N H. So this H will combine with this N. And here Br will combine with this particular electron of this carbon. Okay. I will get product, main major product is Br, no doubt, very simple, Br, okay. So, N-bromosuccinamide, it is used as a brominating agent, okay.
Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.